Hey you, and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry, and in this whole video I'm going to go over having better security within your Chromebook. I'll be going over and showing you how to turn on two-step verification, as well as how to turn on protection so that you'll be notified if anything happens, such as a data breach, or if any strange malicious software comes in through an extension. So, let's check this out, you and I. Come on. Hey, here I am in my Chromebook. Now what you want to do is you want to load a new tab, as you've seen here, so you get to google.com. And once you're at google.com, as you see here, it should say Google in the middle, and it should have your avatar at the very top. Now, take your mouse and find that avatar, go ahead and click it, and then click on Manage Your Google Account. And now it comes up to where it says Google Account, click on Security. It should not say Security and Privacy, it should only say Security. Let's go ahead and click on Security. Now you're in the Security page. You'll need to scroll down a little bit until you find that where it says two-step verification, it'll say off. Go ahead and click there to be turning it on. Now two-step verification will protect your account, and each time you sign in to your Google account, you'll need the password and the verification code when you click or log into a new device. It'll add an extra layer of security for you when you're logging into new devices. On the same devices, you don't need to do that every time. So enter in your password and unique verification code that's sent to your phone. Keep the bad guys out. Even if someone gets your password, it won't be enough to actually sign in to your Google account. Go ahead and click on Get Started. And once you're doing that, then you need to log in to your account to prove that you are you. It really is you and not someone else acting like you, just to turn on two-step verification, do other things for you. So go ahead and key in your password. And then click on Next. All right, now this two-step verification page opens up. Use your phone as your second step to sign in. You now click on Continue, and it'll have a phone number there. If that's the correct phone number, you want to make sure that's correct. Then you have it sent as a text message or as a phone call. Choose the one that you want, and then click on Send. And now your phone will be receiving this code, and it'll be sent to you. It's a one-time code. You'll then see that code as either a text message or as a phone call, whichever one you decided to go with, and you'll key in that code into that spot. After keying in those numbers, go ahead and click on Next. And then it'll ask you for reals, do you really want to turn on two-step verification? And if you're happy, you're going to be using that phone number, that phone, then go ahead and review the email address to make sure it is the correct email address and the correct devices, and then take your mouse and then click on Turn On, and that's how you turn on two-step verification. There you go. So now you have it, and you have a better secured account. Hey, so in that last segment we learned how to turn on two-step verification, and basically, whenever you log into a new device, that's when you'll get the code on the phone. Not every time that you log into the same device, which is nice and not so annoying. All right, now for this next segment, we're going to learn how to basically turn on active scanning on your Chromebook. Now, Chromebooks do not get viruses as such, nor do they really get, malware, but in extensions, some extensions can basically try to hijack your system. They can do things such as eavesdrop on activity. They can do things such as look at your keys that you're keying in, which would really compromise your security. So what Google has done is they've enabled active protection on your Chromebook to be checking out and making sure none of that actually happens. What we're going to do is we're going to go into your settings on your Chromebook and make sure that those protections are turned on. Now there are different levels of protection, and I'll be going over those and how they differ. Chrome account also looks into your passwords. Now, if any password is compromised for a particular device, then it will also come up on this list, which is kind of nice. Other things it looks for is it'll look at your email account or the name of the email account, and if that particular address is found in a pasty site. A pasty site basically is a hacker's website where they sell thousands or millions of credentials at a go. And so we call these pasties because basically a hacker broke in and there was a data breach. He stole or she stole addresses and other credentials from a database and then copied them and then pasted the information onto a pasty site. And there at the pasty site would basically be a long string of email addresses as well as other credentials. There may be other information there as well. And if your information ever comes up on one of those pasty sites, then right away you get a notification saying, hey, something's happened. You've been involved with a data breach. Some of your information may have been leaked because it's coming up on this other website, this hacker's website. So basically it will take you through the steps on how to secure your account. Normally all we have to do is change or update your email, or not your email, but your password. And then you can also turn on two-step verification, which we've already done. So let's go in now and check to make sure that you have full protection in your Google account. Hey, here I am in my Chromebook again. Now what we're going to do is take your mouse and go to the very top there where you see the three dots. That's the Customize Control Google Chrome menu. Go ahead and click on that menu for me. And the menu will come down, and I'll click on Settings. And now we're inside of Settings. Notice we have the search box there in the dark blue. Click in there and key in the word clean. Now as you type in the word, you'll see the search results that come up. And one of the search results that does come up that you may notice, it says passwords, three compromised passwords on mine. Well, that's because I use routers at school, and the routers have the factory default passwords on them, and I'm not allowed to change them. And so anytime that the password is the default password, such as within a router, it'll come up as a compromised password, and it'll give you a chance to actually update or change that password. Now in the case of those routers, I'm not allowed to change those passwords because they are the school's router. Now in your case, let's say that you're at home and you see this, well, it'll give you a chance to go in there and then change or update those passwords on your accounts, and that's highly recommended, that you change the password from something that it came with, so it's not the default password. Next, we're going to click on Security. Now we're inside of Security. Notice we have what says Safe Browsing, Enhanced Protection, Faster Proactive Protection Against Dangerous Websites, Downloads, and Extensions. It warns you about password breaches and requires browsing data to be sent to Google. And this is the very first option there. Next, predicts and warns you about dangerous events before they happen, keeps you safe on Chrome, and may be used to improve your security in other Google apps when you are signed in. Improve security for you and everyone on the web. It warns you if passwords are exposed within a data breach. This is awesome. Next, it sends the URLs to Safe Browsing to check them. And it also sends a small sample of pages, downloads, and extensions activity and system information to help discover new threats. Temporary links this data to your Google account when you are signed in to protect you across your Google apps. So this very first one there, that's the enhanced protection, and it'll actually warn you before things happen. The next one we have there is standard protection. Standard protection against websites, downloads, and extensions that are known to be dangerous. This detects and warns you about dangerous events when they happen. Checks URLs with a list of unsafe sites stored in Chrome. If a site tries to steal your password or when you download a harmful file, Chrome may also send URLs including bits of page content to safe browsing. And so that's basically the next one down there. Now we have other options such as help improve security on the web for everyone. That could be either on or off. And it's best to have that on so that you're helping others there. So all you have to do is click it to turn that on if you want to. The next option that we have there is it warns you if passwords are exposed in a data breach. Chrome periodically checks your passwords against a list that have been published online. When doing this, your passwords and usernames are encrypted, so they can't be seen by anyone, including Google Chrome. And always have that option turned on as you see it on mine. And that's for the best protection there. And the last option there, it says no protection. You always want that off because you always want to have some protection. Under advanced, it says use secure DNS. We won't really get into the details for this episode, but you always want that on, of course, and that encrypts all of your data and has a secure connection for you. So now you know how to keep your Google Chrome account safe within your Chromebook. There's all the options for you, and you have the enhanced protection or the standard protection as the two options there that are recommended there, as well as the other things we've talked about. Both the enhanced and the standard protection scan your Chromebook for malware and viruses in the extensions, apps, and downloaded files. So they both serve to protect your account as well as the files that you have on your Chromebook. Hey, so now you know how to turn on two-step verification, which is really good for keeping your account secure. And you know how to turn on protection within your Chromebook to be having safe browsing. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, because I love reading your comments. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. Hey, thank you very much, and you have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.